Hello everyone, this is Sumita Gupta. Today we will learn Python using virtual lab. So for that, first go to Google and type Python using virtual lab. Python using virtual lab. Click on that. Then the first option, vlab.iitb.ac.in. Click on this. Okay. There's click on list of experiments. There are different experiments. So first let's see arithmetic operation. Okay, this is basically for beginners. So in this experiment, students will learn what is the basics of arithmetic operations. And theories is given there. What is adding, addition operator? What is subtraction? What is multiplication? What is division, modulus, exponent, floor division? Theory is given here. Pre-test for your self-knowledge. What should be the output? 2 to the power 3, 10 modulus 3. So in this way, you can learn yourself. Then procedure, how to do programming. Then simulation. In simulation, in arithmetic operation, different operations for addition. Suppose you're writing first number 3, second number 6. Okay, now we'll do a start. So here the program will be there. And you those who don't know how to write a program, there's steps. And you can check the execution step by step. Like if you first next enter input first number that you have given 3, enter second number that you have given 6, next 9. So yeah, this is your output. Addition is 9. Okay. Now, if you reset, then you can select anyone else. Like you can subtraction, you can select for multiplication, you can select for division. Okay. So this is for arithmetic operation. In the same way, go to the list of experiment, then go in built-in function. Sometimes you have to use some many built-in function. So you can check in theory. ID is for identity of object and type for finding the type, whether it's integer, float, or a string. Okay, let's see in simulation. Here, function by type. If you want to know the type, if you want to know the identity, just click integer and enter any integer. And remember the ID is different, unique for different integers. It will start right. Define identity, identity of A, and A is inside the C and print C. This identity is fixed. Now you want to know the type of that function. First enter something. Suppose I'm writing welcome and start. So see, define and type that is string. I have entered the string. So in this way, you can find the type of the function. Okay. Next we will see loops. And you know the loops, if, as, for loop, while loop, there are many loops. So in loop, you know, if loop, for loop, while loop. So here there's theory is given for loop, for while loop. Now go to the simulation. Okay, in simulation, suppose for finding factorial, we want to apply some loop. Suppose we want to find the factorial of 6, submit C. For loop means there is a range from start to end. Okay, and plus 1. So factorial equals to 1 means we have taken one variable that is defined 1. If you are giving number less than 0, so it will print factorial for negative number doesn't exist. And the story is end here. But if number is not 0, like I have entered 6, so 6 is not less than 0, it will come to else if. Now equals to 0, no, it's not 0, else. Now the loop will again start from 1 to num plus 1. 1 to number 1 to 0, number plus 1, whatever number you have defined. And the factorial equals to factor into I. See, I you have defined 6, now factor is 1, the 1 into 1, 1 into 2, 3, 4, like this, the 6, the 1 into 2, into 3, into 4, into 5. So let's see. 720. Okay, 1 into 2, into 3, into 4, into 5, the factor is 720. So like that, you can check for prime number also. So that I'm leaving for you. Next is data types. Okay, now in data types, you can check the theory. Data types, now it's important, list, tuple, dictionary. And you know list, tuple, dictionary, which is mutable, which is immutable. So you know the tuple is immutable, mutable means which cannot be updated, but list can be updated and dictionary can be updated. And you can follow my previous lecture, I have already explained in detail. Now simulation. Now here, either you can do for list, tuple, or dictionary. So for list, I'm giving first value ABC, second is something else, third is something else, and start. So So how to write program? List is always defined in the square bracket. Okay, if you print the list. Okay, so this is for list. Now reset it. Now we'll check for tuples. Tuple, I'm giving the same thing, something and any value. Just to save the time, I'm just typing right like this. See. So what is the difference between list and tuple? First is a symbol, there's a square bracket here, small bracket, and then it is not a mutable, it's immutable. Okay, same you can do for dictionary. For dictionary, you know, some association will should be there. So it will take 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, see here. We have not defined the like list is items associated with these key values. Okay. But we have given only key values, but not items defined. So 0 for ABC, 1 is for second number, 3 for, 0 is for ABC, 1 is for EDF, JBP, and 2 for this. So it has taken 0, 1, 2, if you have not defined. Okay, that is for dictionary. So this is data types. Next is strings. Okay, in data types also, okay, only that is defined. I was thinking something different. Okay, now next is come to string. Okay, now a string, the theory is there. Okay, what is string is any number inside the single quote or double quote is your string. Now a string, concatenation means a string in Python is immutable. It cannot be changed once defined, but concatenation is possible. Yes? Okay, like hello world and you are adding something else. So it will be hello world example. Means you are adding two different strings. Okay. Repetition can be possible. Slicing can be possible. Indexing can be possible. Let's see how. Go to this. Now I'm writing first string welcome. And second string Ramesh. Any name I have just taken. Start. Okay. And the first starting index. Okay, the starting index was W. That is here. Okay, now slicing how to do? Suppose I'm taking welcome. Starting index is 1. Start. Starting index was 2. I have taken. In welcome, W start from 0. E is 1. L is 2. So L and C is 3. So it is starts from starting number 0, 0, 1, 2, and is n minus 1, 4 minus 3, that will end at 3. Okay, that is for slicing. Now next was reverse. Okay, so whatever string you will enter, it will print the reverse value. Okay, I have reset it. Welcome, then start. Next, see, the welcome is opposite printed. Okay, so that is for reverse repetition. Okay, first is a string you want to repeat and how many times. Suppose I want to repeat four times. Start S multiply by N. See, welcome is printed 4 times. That is called repetition. Okay, in concatenate. You want to string add it. So welcome to virtual lab Python. So all the strings should be added. Okay. So enter the string, enter second string, enter optional string, then first two will be added, then after this, all three will be added. Let's see. Welcome to virtual lab Python. Okay, that was for concatenate, slicing, reverse repetition done. Okay, so this was for a string. In the next lecture, we will learn about the classes and objects. So thank you so much. Keep learning, keep sharing. God bless you.